This is the Tennisnerd racket review of the HEAD Graphene 360 Speed Pro. I must admit I had some doubts before testing this racket. While I used to happily play with various HEAD rackets, I have not really enjoyed a HEAD racket since they introduced Graphene. Did they get it right this fourth time around? I hope I can answer that in this HEAD Graphene 360 Speed Pro racket review. So what is graphene? Graphene is a form of carbon that they say is the strongest material ever tested, according to Wikipedia. And HEAD also won Popular Science Best of What's New award in 2013 when they introduced this material in their HEAD Graphene Speed Pro. 5 years ago, that's when they started using graphene. I'm not sure what the sales have been for HEAD, but I guess they've been pretty good since they've decided to stick with the material in their rackets. They went through various iterations. There was graphene, then graphene XT, where they claimed to shift the weight towards the tip and the grip, which is basically called polarization. A lot of complaints came in that the rackets were too stiff with a lot of recreational players and on tennis forums, increasing the risk for tennis elbow and wrist injuries. So in the third iteration of graphene, which was called graphene touch, the main purpose was dampening shock. So they added a shock absorbing material to the frame construction and claimed that it would reduce vibrations and increase feel. Personally, I felt the rackets became a little too dampened, which I also think is the case with the countervail technology that Wilson uses, and it was quite hard to tell where you hit the ball. So what is new this time with the HEAD Graphene 360? Well, it means that they have increased distribution of graphene around the frame, so this extremely strong material is now not only in the shaft, but also at 3, 9 and 12 o'clock, which is where you usually add lead tape. So I think that makes a lot of sense if you want to increase the power, stability and the swing weight of the racket. Obviously, this is a light material, so it still maintains a very light, fast feel. Do they still have the shock absorbing material? I don't really know. I can try to do more research around that. The idea of the HEAD Graphene 360 is that the racket will play more stable, and the 360 Speed Pro really is a lot more stable than the weight would make you guess. However, I think they have managed to improve the feel, so it's more of a direct arm-friendly feel in the Graphene 360 Speed Pro. What you usually talk about with tennis rackets is about feeling connected to the ball, and I really feel that this has been a big improvement from HEAD with this Graphene 360. And it's so important to know where in the string bed you hit the ball. You need to let your racket and strings transfer the information to your hand and mind. So that's how you become a better tennis player, how you learn to adapt your shots. The racket doesn't do everything, but what you want from your only tool on the tennis court is to get the information to help you become a better player. And it makes you play more freely with more touch and confidence. So good on HEAD for sticking with their plan of graphene, but trying to improve it all along. And it's really been a journey if you look at the different iterations, from too stiff to even stiffer to too muted. And now that I think they finally found a decent level where the graphene makes sense, but the racket is still very playable, not too stiff. Very interesting racket. They've also worked on the aerodynamics of the racket, making it swing faster with the design of the throat and also the grommets. So I think that you get a really fast swinging feel with the Graphene Speed Pro. What I also like is that the tight string pattern gives you more control, so you can really go all in with your shots and still expect a control response from the rackets. So the specs with the 1820 string pattern, it's an open 1820 but still an 1820. It's a 100 square inch head and a 23 millimeter beam, which is a slightly thicker beam than the previous version. It's a good blend to be able to hit hard and generate both spin and power. I did not really find any weaknesses with this racket, and that's a rare thing for me. I usually notice something that I don't like, and then it's obviously a give or take if you love the racket or not. I enjoyed hitting both front and back of the court, very nice and stable on volleys, even in stock form. I ended up adding lead tape at 12 o'clock and in the throat to increase the swing weight just a little bit. I only added 4 grams total, so not a huge deal besides the overgrip. So I want to maintain the fast feel of the racket. I feel that this is very important with this racket, that it allows you to swing with good racket head speed, when I added lead tape at 3 and 9, I felt like the high twist weight made the racket a bit more sluggish through the air, and that wasn't really what I liked. Some lead tape at 12 should be good enough. If you want to increase the swing weight without changing the balance too much, you can add it in the throat of the racket. That's a location that's often overlooked, and I think I can really recommend doing that if you want to maintain balance and still get a bit of a weightier response. I strung this up with Solinco Hyper G, which is one of my go-to strings. Polyester string, it is not super stiff, offers really good spin, and lasts a reasonable amount of time. This does not strike me in any way as a string-sensitive racket. I could try this with a Head Hawk Touch, which is another favorite string of mine these days, and it would probably play the same. So not a string-sensitive racket. A hybrid would add a bit more power and comfort, so that could also be an interesting setup, which I'm going to try as well. So I really like the HEAD Graphene 360 Speed Pro. I don't have a lot of bad things to say about it. Just a very balanced racket from all areas of the court. There's simply not much I don't like about it. I think it's one of the best playtests, performance-wise, for me personally, I've done all year. So it's really interesting to see a 100 square inch racket, which usually feels sluggish to me. This one is really fast through the air. I ended up with 337 grams and a 32.3 centimeter balance. Pretty much spot on, a bit higher than I'm playing these days with my soft drives. But with this racket, it's a bit faster. I think the weight helps me a bit. So really nice, solid playtest. Can really recommend you trying this racket. If you want a lighter racket for more customization options, you can check out the HEAD Graphene 360 Speed MP, which is mid plus. It offers an more open string pattern, 1619, and 10 grams less weight. Otherwise, they play pretty much exactly the same, I would guess. So, but it gives you more room to play around with weight, also gives you a bit more spin. But if you want a control response, nice feeling frame, then you have a stellar racket here from HEAD. So kudos to them for insisting that graphene is a material that belongs in tennis rackets. They finally proved that this is the case. For me, I was skeptic for a long time, but now I'm getting on their side. So well done. Thanks for watching the review and checking out Tennisnerd. Any questions about the review, you can always check out the comments field on the written post on tennisnerd.net or in YouTube or on Instagram in the message field. So go ahead, try this racket. I really like it. If I will switch to this, remains to be seen, but I will keep you posted as always. Thank you.